So now we are going to have our second and last lecture on persuasion. What we'll talk about is the sleeper effect and how people are persuaded. And the sleeper effect is essentially if you give somebody a weak argument and then much later ask them for their attitude towards something, they actually may change their mind and have an attitude that's in favor because they forget initially why they had a negative attitude and they just remember that somebody told them they should have a positive attitude. So, if in week one, here's this guy who says to you, hey, you should take supplements, and he's this weird guy, and you're like, that's a really weak argument. No, I'm not taking supplements. I have an anti-supplement attitude. Well, if we come back to you in week three, you'll have forgotten that the argument was weak, and instead, all you'll just remember is that somebody was telling you to take supplements. And so now you have this pro-supplement attitude. So that's the sleeper effect. It took a while, but you actually ended up reversing your position because you forgot why you didn't like the supplements in the first place and you just remember that somebody told you you should take supplements. Innoculation is a way to help people resist persuasion. So here we have the same situation where somebody is exposed to a weak argument, and now they have this anti-supplement attitude. But this time, instead of waiting 3 weeks, in a half an hour, what we're going to do is we're going to give them a strong argument now for supplements. So you still have this anti-supplement attitude that you developed from the weak argument, and you're going to defend that anti-supplement attitude, and now you're going to have a really strong anti-supplement attitude. Forewarning is another way to help people resist persuasion. So when you forewarn somebody, you're essentially saying, hey, this persuasive attempt is coming, and that person now has the time to gear up for that persuasive attempt and to make sure that he or she is not persuaded. So, for example, I know when I go to buy electronics, they're probably going to make a pretty strong argument for me to buy a warranty. But I know that the electronics that I'm buying, because I've researched them really well, tend not to break. So I know that they're going to be giving me this persuasive attempt. And so I have the time to gear up and develop my own counter arguments against this strong argument to get a warranty. And so now I know when I go, I'm like, okay, I can handle it. If they're going to ask me to get a warranty, I already know what I'm going to say. So I am going to be able to resist that persuasive attempt. Lastly, reactance occurs when people want to have independence. And if somebody tells them what to do or what to say, they want to continue to be independent. So they will actually do the opposite thing on purpose to assert their independence. And this GIF, I think, is a great example. So she's saying, you know what? I'm not going to do what somebody else tells me to do. I don't like it. It doesn't make me feel good. And I feel like I'm, you know, not going to do it. So she's sort of talking about reactance.